So a 34-year-old male came with the symptoms of bleeding per rectum along with increased frequency of stool since last Wednesday. Initially, it was mixed with blood every time he passed stool. So about 8 to 10 frequency of stool per day, and most of the time it is bloody and sometimes frank blood in the stools. Along with this, he had pain in his abdomen, especially in the lower right and left quadrant. There was constant heaviness sensation in the abdomen which remained for the whole day. The stools would be mucoid, semi-solid in consistency, and there was constant urging for stool. So this was his main chief complaint, for increased frequency of stools with lot of pain in the abdomen, with lot of almost like tennis muscle like symptoms, constant desire, stools were bloody, mucoid, semi-solid in consistency, and at times frank blood also. Already on allopathic treatment, but with no relief. He was on steroids as well as on misocol, the standard treatment for ulcerative colitis. On and off steroids were given for a long time, and with that also he was already on, as I said, misocol 2 times a day without any appreciable relief. Initially this patient went to one of my assistants, ex-assistants, and she treated him for 3 years, almost 2.5 to 3 years, and he used to get on and off better and later on worse, better, worse, better, worse. Partially he was cured but never completely cured. After treating for 3 years, finally she decided that okay, it was enough is enough. She knew that he was not getting better totally, so she sent him to me. And when he came to me, this patient was already in a very acute crisis. Acute crisis with every day about 8 to 10 stools, very bloody. He could not eat anything. If he would eat anything immediately, there would be severe abdominal pain. After eating immediately, he would have to rush to the toilet. And also because of this, he was started losing weight, and also he was starting to become anemic. His hemoglobin had already started to drop, and had dropped drastically, and he had lost about 3 to 4 kgs of weight. Along with this, he even complained of cramping pain in legs, especially in the calf area. Appetite, moderate, but he prefers warm food, and even during the acute episode, even during the acute crisis, he wanted warm food. Stools, as you know, I told you the chief complaint, urine was normal, thirst was normal, about 6 to 7 glasses of normal the room temperature, water, cravings for cold drinks, fruits, and as I said, he liked warm food, which was also there during the acute also. Aversion, some vegetables, which is standard. India may now, the biggest problem that we have is the repertories which we have, they are all published in the Western world, Western countries. So when we want to have our cravings and aversions, we don't find it. So one thing, if anybody wants to do a good service in homeopathy, or uska naam ho jayega homeopathy mein, har ek homeopath usko yaad karega, to a repertory likho, wo bhi Indian foods ka repertory likho. Cravings and aversions of Indian foods ka ek repertory likho, oh hit ho jayega. Agar aap likhoge na, your name will become Amar in homeopathy. Craving for pav bhaji. Abhi kahan se dhundu main, kahan se lau? Pani puri. Pani puri to chalo abhi bhi hai, it is a sweet and sour combination, so you can take that. Pav bhaji kahan se nikalo? Vada pav kahan se nikalo? You know, so you need to have Indian repertory. Of course, so everybody has aversion to Turai and Karela. Okay, so there's some vegetables here, some aversion. Perspiration, not much, occasionally only on palms and soles with burning in them, especially in summer. Sleep, insomnia because of thoughts about stress of work as well as about disease. He was very, very worried about the disease. Obviously anybody who's suffering for 3 to 4 years from this kind of a severe disease, I'm sure he's going to be upset. It was affecting his work. He could not go to work regularly. Financially it was affecting him, and also he had some financial troubles because his business was doing not very well. He sleeps on his sides. Dreams, he gets plenty, but he does not remember in the morning. This is very important. Thermals. Earlier to the disease, he was definitely hot. But since the disease, he has become more chilly. He needs blanket in Mumbai winters. and he often complains of burning in his soul. So now what should we take here? Thermals. Now this is a very tricky, we give tremendous importance to thermals. It is a very, very strong physical general, which on the basis of which we rule out or rule in remedies, right? So now in this case, as well as normally, thermals is a very contentious topic, you know, especially in patients. And many a times you will find, summer mein jab patients aayenge, everybody is hot. And winter mein aayenge, everybody is chilly. Especially, you know, if they are, you are practicing here in Nagpur area, where the climates are very, very extreme, very hot in summer and very cold in winter, I'm sure you will find this. Okay, in Mumbai too, we have a same climate all throughout the year. So again, there, you know, it's very difficult to find out from people what they can tolerate more, extreme heat or extreme cold. Kabhi sir gaya hi nahi, to kahan se malum padega? But then there are ways to find out. So if somebody who needs blankets in Mumbai winter, where there is no winter at all, believe me, when I say it is winter, just what I mean is December, November, December, January. If somebody comes to us in Mumbai, we call that as winter. That would be, you know, if he needs blankets in that kind of weather where the temperature is still the same as summer, only about 1 or 2 degrees less, if he needs blanket or if he can live without fan, definitely that person is chilly. Now here, this patient was initially hot and now he has become chilly. What should we take?
Hot.
ये होम्योपैथी में अच्छा है, बस दो ही चीज रहता है तो कुछ भी बोल देने का, एक हॉट बोलो चिली बोलो, आधे जन हॉट बोलो आधे जन चिली बोलो. If you want to take hot, why hot? And if you want to take chili, why chili? Explain to me, please. Yes, one by one. Tell me, yeah. Yes. We should take hot. Why? Okay, earlier is hot, now is chili. So you think you should take hot because that is the original thermals. Broke the patient. Okay, fine. And yes. Huh. Very good. Excellent. मुझे नहीं मालूम था हनीमून ने दिया है क्या ऑर्गन में. अच्छा अच्छा. Thank you. As I said, I'll get learning, some learning from you also. Yes, हनीमून ने कहीं तो लिखा है ऑर्गन में, कहाँ लिखा है? Aphorism number नहीं मालूम है. You have to take the whatever is the change state in the patient. Okay, चलो सब ये लॉजिक हो गया ना, तो इसका मतलब अपने को चिली लेना चाहिए. अभी एक हाइपोथायरायडिज्म का पेशेंट आया गया और बोलता है बहुत ठंडी लग रही है, समर में भी नागपुर का 47 डिग्री में भी बोलता है मुझे रात को ब्लैंकेट चाहिए, क्या लेना चाहिए? चिली लेना चाहिए. पहले हॉट था, अभी हाइपोथायरायडिज्म के बाद चिली हो गया. अच्छा, एक मेनोपॉजल फीमेल आई, बोलती पहले मैं बहुत ही चिली थी, अभी तो इतना गर्मी होता है एक सेकंड पंखे के बिना नहीं चलता है, एक सेकंड एसी के बिना नहीं चलता है, क्या लेना चाहिए? Yes, very good. One, it is the common symptom of the disease because that is the manifestation of the disease itself. In hypothyroidism, intolerance to heat or cold is a symptom of the disease, not the symptom of the patient. And what do we treat? We treat human beings who are suffering from disease and not the disease. So, the same way, menopause is a physiological alteration of a person's tolerance to heat or cold, which is now happened because, and it is temporary, it's not permanent. While now here, in syphilitic cases, now I'll tell you why we need to take the altered state. This is a syphilitic disease, and in syphilitic diseases, you will find that the thermals, thirst or the generals of the patients tend to change. In psoriatic, if it will change, it will be only temporary. The thermals, if at all a person is hot, in acute it will become chilly, he will be only chilly during that acute episode and again he will come back to that original thermals. While in syphilitic, once the thermals or thirst or any physical general has changed, it usually does not revert back. So in acutes, why in acutes we take the thermal thirst chart is because of that with the thermals are temporary change, you give a temporary remedy, the state is cured, again the patient goes back to his original. Here he's already changed for good forever, now his thermals are going to remain chilly forever, he's not going to change back to hot. So when you say childhood thermals, it has to be taken in soaring cases. If you are going to prescribe a constitutional for him, yes, you have to take hot in a soaring case. But in a psychotic or syphilitic case usually, and in syphilitic usually the thermals change once and for all, they never come back. So you have to take the changed state, the altered state. Right? Okay. So yes, definitely we need to take chili here. So the patient is chili and he often complained of burning in soles. Son, no complaints. Past history, he suffered from tuberculosis of lungs at the age of 15 years. And he has taken anti-tubercular treatment. Remedy is very clear, na? Ah, simple. Past history of tuberculosis, chili patient. Tuberculinum. De do, khatam ho gayi baat. Phosphorus. Very good. Very good. Nice. So, practically, every patient who walks into our clinic, especially in city like Mumbai, where it is very crowded, and every day millions of tuberculosis germs are being pushed at you from your neighbor, from your kamwali bhai, from the person standing next to you in the train, in the bus, he's sneezing on your face, he's coughing on your face. Every day we are exposed to at least 1 billion germs, tuberculosis germs every day. So we all should take tuberculin, right, in Bombay? Huh? This is not. If it is important, if I have suffered from measles 20 years ago, do you think it is still important?